Now that we know what to do when we have complex conjugate roots of the characteristic equation, we can try and work an example. So let's solve x double dot plus x equals 0 with initial conditions x of 0 equals 1 and x dot of 0 equals 0. We try our ansatz as always, try x equals e to the rt. We get the characteristic equation r squared plus r plus 1 equals 0. We use the quadratic formula here. So r plus and minus equals negative b, negative 1, plus or minus the square root of b squared, 1, minus 4ac, minus 4, over 2a, 2. And we notice that those are complex numbers. So this is minus 1 half plus or minus I times root 3 divided by 2. Okay, so this is the case of complex conjugate roots of the characteristic equation. We know now how to find two real functions, so let me write them down. We have, let's just write the general solution using our two real functions. So we have x of t is equal to, we have a real exponential function in both terms, so e to the minus t over 2. And then the complex, the imaginary part of r goes as the frequency in the cosine and the sine term. So we have a constant a times cosine root 3 over 2t plus another constant b times the sine root 3 over 2t. And that's the general solution then in the case when we have complex conjugate roots of the characteristic equation. Okay, we have two free coefficients here, a and b, and we have to use them to satisfy these two initial conditions. So unfortunately, we have to take the derivative of this. We're going to have to use the product rule to do that. So we're going to need x dot of t. So let's do that relatively slowly. So it's the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. So the derivative of the first gives us minus 1 half e to the minus t over 2 times the second, which is a cosine root 3 over 2t plus b sine root 3 over 2t. Plus the first times the derivative of the second. The derivative of the second is always going to, using the chain rule, is always going to bring out a root 3 over 2. So we have plus root 3 over 2 times e to the minus t over 2. And then the derivative of cosine is minus sine. So we have minus a sine root 3 over 2 t, and the derivative of sine is cosine, so plus b cosine root 3 over 2 t. And that's the derivative. Okay, it's unavoidable to have this long expression, but when we plug in x of 0 and x dot of 0, things will simplify. So let me write it up here. X of 0 equals 1. So put in t equals 0, e to the 0 is 1, cosine of 0 is 1, sine of 0 is 0. So x of 0 is just equal to a, and that's supposed to be equal to 1. So we get a equals 1. Okay? How about x dot of 0? X dot of 0, we have minus 1 half times e to the 0, so minus 1 half. The sine will be 0, and we'll end up with a. So minus 1/2 a. And then the second piece here, we have a plus root 3 over 2, e to the 0 is 1. Sine of 0 is 0. Cosine of 0 is 1. So plus root 3 over 2b. And that's supposed to be equal to 0. So we can use this second equation to solve for b. So root 3b is equal to a. A is 1, so root 3b equals 1, and then multiply by root 3 and divide by 3, so we get b is equal to root 3 divided by 3. Okay, so what is our solution here? Our solution for x is given by this expression, and then we've determined what a is, and we've determined what b is. That's the solution then to the differential equation and the initial conditions. So let me summarize what I've done. I'm solving x double dot plus x dot plus x equals 0, and looking for the solution that also satisfies these two initial conditions. When I try our ansatz, x equals e to the rt, we end up with complex conjugate roots of the characteristic equation. Then we can use that root, those roots, to do the principle of superposition the first time to construct two real solutions. The two real solutions are e to the minus t over 2, the minus 1/2 goes in the exponential, and cosine root 3 over 2t, that's from the imaginary part, and then sine root 3 over 2t from the imaginary part. So we can just immediately write down the general solution of a differential equation with complex conjugate roots. Then we need to satisfy the two initial conditions. Unfortunately, we have to differentiate this, but then when we substitute in t equals 0, we get some relatively simple a relatively simple linear system to solve for a and b, and then we solve that, and then we have the solution that satisfies both the differential equation and the two initial conditions. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.